Today, I'm going to share with you my 5 favorite legal golf technologies. What's happening, Panda Nation? Peter Von Panda here. Maybe you like to golf. Maybe you just want to get better. Maybe you want every little advantage that you can think of. I have been experimenting with so many golf technologies over the last couple years that I wanted to bring you my 5 favorite ones, the ones that I think deliver the most value, and all of these are absolutely legal, so if you aren't using them yet, you might want to. So the first thing that I like is the TPF Golf Lightweight Driver Heads. First of all, this is kind of an off-brand, all-titanium, no-frills driver head that I actually have been using myself. And despite the fact that I have been using the Callaway and TaylorMade's and Radspeed drivers and all that, I find myself putting this TPF golf driver in my bag a lot because it's just really good. Now, the sound is pretty loud, but the nice thing about this driver head is that you can remove weights and get the driver head down to 176 grams, but you can also weight it up to over 200 grams, so you can really find the sweet spot for you. And in my research, I was finding that the average golfer in America is 54 years old. So what ends up happening is that we get weaker, less limber, and so it's harder to get that club head speed up. And so one of the things that we can do to just make it easy on us to get the swing speed up is to use a lighter driver head. And this TPF Golf driver head is fantastic for that because it sounds great, it goes a mile, it's very forgiving, and yet you can customize the weights to get that weight down. In many ways, this is what has made Zexio so popular. And so I did a video about that driver and I said this is one way to make your own Zexio alternative that doesn't cost a lot of money. So I really love that driver head. I think it's a great driver head for anyone who wants a little lighter club to get the swing speed up and wants something that performs really, really well. Number 2, torque balanced putters. So this is something that I only found recently and I absolutely love it. So a number of companies actually build putters that are meant to reduce the torque or the twisting as you are swinging them. So Axis One, Adele putters, and the one that I'm gaming right now is from Lab Golf. And so all of these putters are really good. But so many times, especially when we have light grips and we rock that putter back and forth, the putter head is working against us. It wants to open or close on its own because of the way it's weighted. But a torque balanced or torque free or torque less or reduced torque putter head is staying pretty stable. And so it's one of those things that helps you as you're putting to just keep that face square to your target. And so that's something that I think is just a no-brainer because we don't want that twisting when we're putting. And this is just going to make it that much easier on you. So no torque, less torque. Torque-free putters, I think, are the way to go. Number 3. Now, this is a technology I wish I could combine with the torque-free putters, but it's the MLA putter alignment technology. So MLA putters, while they're pretty traditional putters, you can get them in mallet and blade styles, I really like them for this alignment line, this kind of C-shaped, crescent-shaped alignment line on the top because they absolutely do work. And for a lot of people that have a little trouble aligning to the hole, I know some people will use the Callaway dual ball. Some people will use a really elongated mallet head with long lines on it. Some people use the triple track lines, whatever it might be. But these MLA lines are scientifically proven to help you align towards the ball. And they work for me. They might not work for everyone, but I absolutely love that alignment aid and it works really well. It's one of those things that I almost thought about having cut out of vinyl and then putting it on my torque-free putter. That's how much I like it. So if you find yourself thinking that you're lined up to the target and then you look back at your putter and you're not aligned, well, I would definitely check out the MLA putters. They absolutely work. Number 4, the Jumbo Max grips, and specifically the Jumbo Max Straight Tech Ultralight grips. I have absolutely loved these. They are on all my clubs, so it's one of those grips that's not tapered. So if you're choked down, you don't get a really small, thin part of the grip, and your hands and your grip are now in a different position. And it's nice and large so that your hands don't twist and rotate as much either. And it allows you to get more gripping surface so that you can have a little bit lighter grip on the club. I absolutely love them, but people like Bryson DeChambeau are using jumbo grips obviously very effectively as young, strong guys. And so it's one of those things where I might suggest trying a slightly larger grip. It has made a world of difference for me. That is full show. And number 5, and this is where we're going to get into the pricey part of this segment, but it's the Auto Flex Shaft. Now, you've probably seen some videos about it, and it really does add anywhere from 3 to 8 miles an hour to your swing speed. I know a lot of people are getting right in that 3, 4, 5 mile per hour club head speed improvement, and so it absolutely does work. It is a little strange feeling because it is so flexible. It's one of those things where, hey, can you just go to a ladies flex or an A flex or something like that and get the same effect? I have tested tested a number of things because I've been hoping that there would be a $100 or $200 shaft that would do what the $600 or $700 or $800 Autoflex shafts do, but I have not been able to find anything that mimics it at all. And so it does work. I'm not sure what the technology is. I'm not sure why there aren't other competitors in this space yet, but the Autoflex shaft absolutely works. It is the easiest and quickest way to add 3, 4, 5 miles an hour to your club head speed on your driver or fairway woods. And I know that they make some iron shafts too. I haven't tested those particularly, but if you are really trying to reach your driver out as far as possible and you have done everything else that you can think of, I actually think the Autoflex shaft could be a really good deal, because between lessons and other technology and trying new drivers each year and trying different balls and all these other things and all these other places that you're spending money, the Autoflex shaft might be able to do more than any of those. So if you have the scratch, it's one of those things that I would definitely test out because it really does work. So hopefully you might find that some or all of these legal golf technologies will help out your game. And if you want to try any of them, I'll put links to them all in the description below. Peter Von Panda, out. We can discover more and explore so much deeper.